Our work is very diverse on various different scales. We see our activity as architects which engage with the social. We believe that in all our projects we offer a structured approach, that is, we devise instruments. We create bases for informal growth. Usually when we do something, it looks as if it has always been there. It is very natural, not in the green sense necessarily, but more in as in self-evident and pertinent. All our work is highly contextual, physically contextual, but also in the continuation of the stories of the place. One of our main beliefs is that space is not unequivocal. The occupants and users of any given space bring their own stories to bear upon. They draw upon these narratives, their backgrounds, and their perspectives to continually recreate the environment in which they find themselves. It is our intention to present sites in an unequivocal manner so that they derive their forms from the subjective meanings supplied by their occupants and users. Our interventions make an environment receptive to its occupants and users. Our projects allow them to appropriate a room, building or district and develop it further. We strive to be the catalyst for such processes, thus creating opportunities for informal evolution. We undertake in-depth research into the narratives and the psychological components of tangible space. We analyze its subjective environment in order to create the conditions for dreams, memories, and associations for individuality. Our strategy thus has an aim but no fixed outcome. This, you might say, integral thinking leads to collaborations with numerous experts in their field. On public projects, we collaborate with artists, cultural producers, planners, sociologists, and structural engineers. For us, collaborative projects have a different nature. They are by definition more open and inclusive than an individual concept. And if it's a good collaboration, it does not become a watered-down compromise, but a rich and multifaceted work, which is able to deal with a lot of aspects and gives answers to more complex questions. When we begin a project, we ask ourselves a lot of questions. Who are the players? Who are the actors, and what happened in the past? An almost archaeological research to get familiar with the place and its inhabitants and let the answer emerge. So it's really not so much a design process, more an emergence. And then it's a matter of linking the various aspects which came up, and this results mostly in a structure. Our projects always turn out to be a structure, more or less. A structure is maybe the most existential part of architecture. A structure which is a tool, a structure which can transform. A structure is something which can be inhabited in a personal or collective way, or a structure which facilitates a performance, offers a roof, but always as something open.